So, Dr. Scholz, today we're talking about intermediate-risk prostate cancer, but what we call teal, and teal is a color used to categorize five different stages of prostate, or one of the five stages of prostate cancer within our PCRI staging system. So a lot of times how people encounter this is they're taking our quiz on our website and they find out that they're in this category. Can you talk about what teal is and what the concept is? I know we have there's a lot to it, and obviously it's quite intricate, so let's just start, I guess, with 3+4 and kind of break it down into the sub-stages.
Yeah, so in the most people are aware of the fact that prostate cancer is this spectrum of harmless to potentially life-threatening. And when you have a spectrum, you have to have a kind of a gray zone in between or a crossover section where it starts going from harmless to more consequential and then even to more dangerous. And teal fits that category, and therefore you can actually break teal into three subcategories. We call it low, basic, and high. The low is kind of like low risk rather than intermediate risk. The high teal is more like high risk than intermediate risk. And then the basic teal is really does sit right in the middle of this no treatment versus aggressive treatment spectrum. It's a category that really has to be broken down further into three subcategories.
So is this, now this is kind of like the cusp, I would think, when it comes to the active surveillance and monitoring versus treatment side. So what is low teal to you?
So low teal are the men that have 3+4. The teal category is characterized by Gleason 7. And that is, the new grade groupings are 1 to 5, so that would be grade groupings 2 and 3. So 7s can be 3+4 or 4+3. And then 3+4 is a fairly broad category. So some of the 3+4s have relatively small amounts of cancer and relatively small amounts of 4. And those tend to behave like low-risk patients and are candidates for active surveillance. That's really what the bottom line is. When we're talking about teal, it's an issue of to treat or not to treat. Can you safely watch it versus should you embark upon treatment? And for the people that aren't initiated to prostate cancer, embarking upon treatment is a big deal because modern therapy has gotten so much better, but it still can't avoid the possibility of causing erectile dysfunction, impotence. And obviously that's a huge thing for men. And if they can safely avoid treatment and avoid the risk of becoming impotent, that's very attractive.
So what would define basic teal versus high teal? I know that we have in low teal 3+4. So does it go to primarily 4 as the main when it comes to basic and high?
So it's probably easier to define high teal. High teal is where the 4 comes before the 3, or if a person has undergone a random biopsy, more at least half of the cores have cancer in them. If the PSA, if you have both a PSA above 10 and and multiple cores, these things all fall toward what we call high teal. The standard approach for high teal has been, for the treatment of high teal, has been to give a combination of hormones for 4 to 6 months plus some sort of radiation. And that's very effective, and the cure rates are very high. There is more side effects, of course, when you use combination therapy. And some high teal patients now are looking at maybe doing focal therapy alone with something like brachytherapy in select cases, and then possibly foregoing hormone therapy in those that don't show metastasis.
Hi everyone, it's Alex and Hunter. Hunter's our official PCRI mascot. If you'd like to learn more about men's health tips and prostate cancer, you can follow him on Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel. We come out with new prostate cancer videos every week. Say bye!